Hi, I'm Tim. Welcome to Watchbox, and thanks for logging on. If you love this watch, email me, tmosso@thewatchbox.com. It's in the description below. Your purchase and pricing email question line for buying this or any watch you see on any Watchbox platform. Reach out to me directly, email tmosso@thewatchbox.com for pricing. Today, we are discussing a 175-piece limited edition made in stainless steel in the year 2005 for German luxury watch retailer Wempe, celebrating 100 years of the retailer. This is the Audemars Piguet Royal Oak Offshore Scuba Wempe 100 Years, a timepiece that retains the essential outline and mechanics of the new for 2004 Royal Oak Offshore Scuba Diver line. It is one of the thinnest Royal Oak Offshores you will ever encounter. As a result, it's more wearable on a small wrist. So 42 millimeters in diameter, the way the Royal Oak Offshore has been since 1993 in its standard form, the real standout dimension here is 12.8 millimeters thick. Do not be fooled. This is as thin as a Rolex Submariner. Lug to lug, you can measure the watch at 53.6 millimeters, but if you include these intermediate links, these little plots that extend, then the rigid distance across the wrist is a meaty 58.2 millimeters. Now, throwing it on my wrist, which is 16 centimeters circumference, you can see that it's broad. I would not recommend an offshore, at least the 42 millimeter offshore, for a wrist smaller than 15 centimeters circumference. I think it just gets a little bit unwieldy when the watch projects out beyond the edge of your wrist. That said, you can see it wears well on my wrist, and with the diver strap, you're giving yourself the best chance of a good fit because this strap is more flexible than, for example, the Hornback alligator leather strap typically used on offshores. You can also see just how flat this really is. It's extraordinary for an offshore to see one this thin, and if you're asking why is that, three reasons. One, this generation had no display case back. Those make watches thicker. Second, this is not the chronograph. The chronograph has a module chronograph movement on a base caliber that makes it thicker. And finally, it uses a JLC 899 base that is thinner than the base calibers used on later Audemars Piguet Royal Oak Offshores that used the in-house 3126 movement. So this is a timepiece that is much thinner than you would expect for an offshore. Taking a look at the hardware and the software, I gave a part of the game talking about the diver strap. It's got nice satin finish, striations that extend from the intermediate links. You can see that the bevel of the caseband actually continues into the shoulder of the strap, and then it thins out as it moves away from the case. This one, as you can see, is in brand new condition, and it's accompanied by a stainless steel folding clasp, the logo style clasp with the AP logo internally, protection against accidentally dropping your expensive and significantly expensive limited edition diver. This is a watch that looks as sharp as the day it left Le Brassus. In terms of refinishing, if it's been polished, it's been maybe once, and then professionally, and I'm talking factory. This watch is incredibly crisp and original. You can see the break between the expanding bevel on the lug hood and the satin finished elements on the caseband and the hood, completely distinct. And you can see that they are distinct as well as symmetrical at all four corners. Metalwork is what you're getting with a watch like this. Hand-finished metal, including tiny bevels on the edge of the crown guard structure, as well as the sharp break between the satin top of the bezel and the rounded polished flank. You can see the attention to detail is superb as there's a narrow satin-finished band on the edge of the bezel, and then there's the polished rounded portion, and then the sharp vertical satin on the top. Hexagonal bolts in stainless steel sunken into the bezel, and you can see the bezel gasket fully expressed. It was a subtle element on the original 1972 Royal Oak by Gerald Genta. The Royal Oak Offshore launched 20 years after the original Royal Oak by Emmanuel Gett. It was a prototype in 1992. It came to market in 1993, and Gett wanted to have a fully expressed bezel gasket, so you can really see it as a styling element of the watch. Now we have polymer shoulders for both the bezel crown and the winding crown, screw down crown, 300 meters water resistant, also a screw down crown for the unidirectional rotating bezel. You line up that triangular index with the minute hand. Now you have an impromptu 0 to 60 minute count up timer. I find this easier to read than the minutes on a Royal Oak Offshore chrono, and you don't have the downstream maintenance costs of the chronograph movement. The timepiece is a dedication to the retailer Wempe, but it is a subtle one, as you can just barely see the Wempe logo and name down at 6 o'clock. Otherwise, you have a feature no longer found on the Royal Oak Offshores. This is the Grand Tapisserie dial, which is cut on a pantograph. The typical Royal Oak offshore uses a stamped megatapisserie dial. So this one still uses the vintage artisanal craft method of setting up a mimicry engine, a lathe that takes a big panel template and then inscribes onto the dial blank the hobnails and the patterns. You'll also note the date on this watch is much closer to the dial under its magnifier because there is no modular chronograph complication on top of the base movement as you would find in the chrono. We have white gold hands, white gold indices. This is an ISO 6425 diver. So in addition to being 300 meters water resistant, you have constant seconds indication, and then you have a movable reference for timing your dive, and that is the unidirectional ratcheting internal bezel. The case back, a lovely and romantic image. Remember, the solid case back makes this watch thinner. 100 years of Vempe, and you can see the lovely image of a vessel on the reverse side. Shades of the Vacheron overseas, but a vessel of a distinctly different era. And inside, a JLC caliber 899. It is the free-sprung unidirectional winding version of the old 889 ultra-thin high horology movement, and it is still ultra-thin and high horology. The 899 is a unidirectional winder with a 38-hour power reserve, quick set date, stop seconds. It pivots on 32 jewels. It beats away at 8 beats per second, and it is free sprung for greater durability than earlier 889s. It also uses a 5-position adjustment that makes this watch quite accurate, and it is a nicely hybrid mechanical and hand-finished movement, so a true high horology movement for a high horology watch. Reach out to Tommaso at thewatchbox.com for purchase and pricing details. Back with the Royal Oak Scuba by night.